Okay, let's get started. All right, I think that's all ready to go and live. All right, great. Hi, everyone. So, welcome to my 60-minute Vinyasa yoga class. This is being streamed on the Whole Health Project by Rachel and Lucy. But after this live stream, it will be saved on the Facebook group page as well, so you're able to watch it as many times afterwards in all the modules that they've created. I'm really pleased to be a part of this, so it's awesome. If you feel inspired or if you've enjoyed the class, I have put my PayPal link below in the description of this video that you can donate to. My suggested donation's about $5 to $20, as it would be generally in Australia for live, like real classes. If donating at the moment isn't feasible to you right now though, then please just enjoy this class as a gift. It's something that I love to do anyway, so I hope you all enjoy. Especially through this crazy time, we all need to be doing things with each other and be kind to one another. This class is going to be very focused on flowing and moving with your breath. So it's going to be very movement based and very flowy. So let's begin. I'm going to put some music on. So hopefully you can all hear it reasonably well. Great. And now let's get started in a child's pose. So big toes to touch, knees apart. And I just want you to walk your fingertips forward, resting your forehead down on the mat. We're going to stay here for a little while. This is the time to ground down on the mat. It's the time to settle in. To forget about whatever you were doing before this and to bring your focus solely inwards. Take note of where you can feel the breath coming in and out of your body. With an inhale, walk your fingertips forward a little. And then exhale, sink your hips down. Lengthening through your side body. Can you relax your shoulders away from your ears just a little bit? Sink your hips down onto your heels a little bit more. Where do you notice your breath? Is it your belly expanding onto your thighs? And then lifting off as you exhale. Or maybe it's your chest expanding and then falling. Maybe it's the cool air rushing in through your nostrils or the warm air coming out over your top lip. Inhale nice and deep. Exhale, walk your fingertips over to the left hand side of your mat for a beautiful right side body stretch. Inhale, walk back to the center.
And on your next exhale, walk over to the other side. Lengthening down through the left side body. On your next inhale, come back to the center and come up to all fours. We'll go through a couple of cats and cows to warm up all through the spine. So on an inhale, you're going to drop your belly, broaden your chest, look up and pull your shoulders away from your ears. Exhale, tuck the hips under, roll into our cat. Inhale. Into our cow, and then exhale, cat. Feel like the movement comes from your hips. So as you inhale, the hips tuck under, belly drops, chest expands, head looks up last. And then exhale like a rolling wave as you tuck the hips, roll the upper spine, head comes down. Inhale. Slowly tilt the hips, belly drops, chest broadens, look up. Exhale, hips tuck under, rolling wave, the head drops down last. Two more like this in your own breath, and maybe incorporate a twist or a barrel roll as you move through. Focusing on flowing where your body needs you to go and moving with your breath. At the end of that second breath, tuck your toes, send your hips back and slowly press up to our first downward dog. Here, bend and straighten the knees lots. Start to warm up into this position. Maybe rock your hips from side to side, giving yourself a little side body stretch. Take this moment as an exploration into your body and how you're feeling today. When you're ready for stillness, we'll stay here for 3 breaths. Every inhale, lengthen through the spine. And then exhale, settle deeper. Inhale, come onto your tippy toes, rolling wave, find our high plank. Exhale, push the hips back. Inhale, coming onto our tippy toes, rolling wave, high plank. Exhale, downward dog. One more time, inhale, rolling wave, high plank. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, high plank. Lower the knees down. And lower down from knees, chest, chin. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, lower. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, lower. Inhale, baby cobra. Press back. Exhale, child's pose. And then when you're ready, tuck the toes, come back up. Downward dog. Inhale, rolling wave, high plank. Lower down, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, child's pose. And then press up, downward dog. Baby cobra. Exhale, press back, downward dog. Take a few long, deep breaths here. And then slowly tiptoe to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rolling one vertebra at a time. Come up to standing. Arms come high. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rolling wave. Come all the way up. Arms follow through. Reach tall. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Come up to standing, rolling through one vertebra at a time. Arms come high, look up, reach high. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step back with the right leg. Inhale, low lunge. Exhale, settle in, shoulders come away from the ears. Inhale, lengthen through the spine, crown of the head reaches up tall, and then exhale, settle down. Again, inhale, reach the fingertips high. Exhale, twist towards that front left leg. Inhale, come back to the center. And then open up towards the right, staying in our low lunge. Inhale to the center. Exhale, pull back, half Hanuman. Inhale, come forward, frame the front foot, step back, high plank. Either knees, chest, chin, or full chaturanga, whatever is in your practice. Lower down on an exhale. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, press back, downward dog. Inhale, the right leg high. Bring the knee nice and close to your nose and step it through. Lower the back knee down, inhale, rise, low lunge. Exhale, ground down, shoulders away from the ears. Inhale, reach the fingertips tall. Exhale, settle. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist towards the right. Inhale, come to the center. And exhale, twist to the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, pull back. Half Hanuman. Inhale, walk the fingertips forward. Straighten the back knee and step forward for the left foot to meet the right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up to standing. Reach up, look up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, place the hands down. Step back with the left leg. Drop the knee down. Inhale, rise, low lunge. Exhale, settle shoulders away from the ears. Inhale, lengthen through the crown of the head. Exhale, twist towards the right. Inhale, center. Exhale, open towards the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, pull back. Half Hanuman. Walk those fingertips forward. Come into our low lunge and step back, high plank. Lower down, knees, chest, chin, or full chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog or cobra. Exhale, press back. Downward dog. Inhale, the left leg high. Bring that knee all the way in, nice and close, step it through. Drop the back knee low, lunge, inhale. Exhale, shoulders away from the ears. Inhale, lengthen through the crown of your head. Exhale, twist towards the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale, pull back. Half Hanuman. One breath here. And then walk your fingertips forward, lift the back leg, and step the right foot to meet the left. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up to standing. Look up, reach up. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Stay here for a moment, close down your eyes. And tune back into your breath. How are you feeling? Where is the energy flowing most? Perhaps your heart rate is lifted a little, and you're starting to feel a little bit of warmth throughout your whole body. We're going to progress that flow. That's our base flow, and we're going to keep progressing it from there. But this time we're going to swap low lunge for crescent. So we'll be up a little bit higher this time. So when we're ready, inhale, arms high, look up, reach. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands down, step the right leg back. Crescent lunge. Keep the back knee lifted this time. Active legs, so active that you can lift your fingertips up and you're not going to collapse. Arms reach back for arrowhead. And then inhale high, crescent lunge. On the exhale, bring those shoulders away from the ears. Inhale, lengthen from the crown of the head. Exhale, twist towards that front leg. Inhale, center. And then we exhale, open up, warrior two. From here, flip that front palm reverse. And then moving forward, forearm comes onto your thigh, reach up and over, extended side angle. You can look down or high. Inhale, come back to warrior two. Reverse. And then windmill back to warrior two. Straighten the front leg. Hinge forward with your left hand, reaching. And when you cannot reach any further, we come into our triangle pose. We want to make sure we're in a nice straight line. So if I'm in triangle facing you, instead of being like this, you want to be directly in a nice straight line. And then hinging down. If that means you can't go as far, then that's okay. You want to be in a nice straight line. From here, I want you to look down at your front foot, bend the knee, warrior two, reverse. And then windmill the hands down, frame the front foot, and step back to our high plank. Lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog or cobra. Exhale, press back. Downward dog. Inhale, the right leg high. Bring that knee all the way in, nice and close, and step it through. Keeping that back leg lifted, arrowhead. Nice, strong legs. Inhale, rise, crescent lunge. Exhale, shoulders away from the ears. Inhale, lengthen from the spine, and then exhale, twist towards your right leg. Inhale, center. Exhale, open up, warrior two. Flip that front palm, reverse. Exhale, come forward. Forearm comes onto the thigh for our first extended side angle. Reach those fingertips up and over. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, reverse. As we come back through our warrior two, straighten that leg, reaching your right fingertips as far forward as you can before we come into our triangle pose. Remember, nice straight line here. We stay here for three breaths. At the completion of your third breath, look down. Bend your knee. Inhale through our warrior two to reverse. And then windmill the hands down. Frame that front foot and step the left leg to meet the right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up to stand. Reach up, look up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, place the hands down, step the left leg back. Arrowhead. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, stay. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, twist towards the right. Inhale, windmill open, warrior two. Exhale, stay. Inhale, flip that front palm, reverse. Exhale, come forward, extended side angle. And if it's in your practice, you may come lower to the ground. One full breath in and out. Inhale, warrior two. Reverse. Straight, move right leg. Triangle. One full breath in here. Stay for the exhale. Bending through that front knee. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, reaching forward now through our warrior two. Shuffle that back foot forward if you need to, and we're coming into half moon. The right hand comes about a foot out and forward from your right foot, and then we come into our half moon. We're still in our warrior two position, hips are open. Left foot back here is active. It's so strong, you're pressing into the back of the room. Your left hand is reaching up towards the ceiling and your right fingertips are grounding down, opening up through the hip. One more full deep breath here. And then twist your torso so now you're neutral. We're in a supported warrior three. And come into standing split, lift that left leg up as high as you can. One more inhale, and then exhale, bring that left foot to meet the right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up to standing, reach up, look up, and then exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, place the hands down, step the right leg back this time. From here, arrowhead. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, stay. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist towards the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, warrior two. Flip that front palm, reverse. And then exhale, come forward, extended side angle. Inhale through warrior two, reverse. And then as you exhale, come forward for triangle. Looking down at that front foot, bend the knee, warrior two, reverse. And then prepare for half moon. So we shift our weight forward. Our left hand comes on the outside of that, a foot forward into the side. So we're at a diagonal from our left foot is our left hand. Shift the weight. Keep the hips open like in our warrior two. Right fingertips are reaching up towards the ceiling. Right foot is reaching towards the back of the room. The top of the head is reaching towards the top of the room. And then breathe here. Bring the right hand down, square the hips off for a supported warrior three. And then dive forward, standing split. Stay for one more inhale. And then on the exhale, bring your right foot to meet the left. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up to stand. Look up, reach up. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Close down your eyes. Resist the urge to fidget. And just take a moment to tune back into your breath and your body. How are you feeling right now? I'm imagining we're all feeling a little bit more heated and a little bit more mobile. Take one more deep breath in together. Exhale, let it go. And we'll get ready to continue to flow again. Inhale, arms high, look up, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands down, step back into high plank. Lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, press back, downward dog. Inhale, the right leg high, bend the knee, open the hip. And then slowly with control, bring your right foot in towards your left elbow. Then straighten the leg, plant down the edge of the foot, and lift the left hand for fall and triangle. If you can, lift the left leg for an added challenge. Inhale, press back up, three-legged dog. And then step through all the way. Inhale, arrowhead. Exhale, crescent lunge. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, twist. Inhale, center. Exhale, warrior two. Flip that front palm reverse. Then exhale, come forward, extended side angle. This time, if it's in your practice, let's add a bind. Looking up. Slowly come back. Inhale, warrior two, exhale, reverse. As we come back through, we're coming into our triangle, reaching the right hand forward, coming down. Reaching the left fingertips up high. Breathe. From here, bend the knee, come back to our warrior two, and just shift the back foot in a little. Bring your right hand onto your hips, straighten both legs and hinge, both looking directly forward. Bring the left hand high and reach forward, reaching down for your shin, your ankle or the outside of your left foot. Bring your right hand onto your pelvis so you can feel that you're nice and square here. And when you feel comfortable, bring that right hand up for a twist. Reverse triangle. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, twist. One more breath here. Stay for the exhale. And then bring that right hand back down and we come back up, opening into our warrior two. Reverse. And then we come forward into our half moon. Now we've built some more confidence and memory in this balance. Maybe you play with taking your right hand off the ground. In this challenging posture, can you bring yourself back to your breath? That's where you have your stability. Supported warrior three. And standing split. On the next exhale, bring your left foot down to meet your right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up to standing. Look up, reach. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step back, high plank. Lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, press back, downward dog. Inhale, the left leg high. Bend the knee, open the hip. And then bring that leg all the way through towards your right elbow. Straighten the leg, nice edge of the foot. Lift your right hand for forward triangle. Perhaps lift your leg if it's available to you. And then on the next inhale, come back. Three-legged dog. Bring your knee all the way in towards your chest as you step it through. Arrowhead. Coming up to our crescent lunge, and on our exhale, shoulders come down away from the ears. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Reaching those fingertips apart. Inhale, center. Exhale, warrior two. Reverse. And then coming forward for our extended side angle. And again, if it's available to you, let's go for a bind. Three breaths here. At the end of the third breath, inhale, warrior two. Exhale, reverse. And then come forward for our triangle. Looking down, come through our warrior two. Reverse. And then as you come forward, step that foot in a little and point it forward. Hands are on your hips, right hand reaches high, leaning forward as far as you possibly can towards the top of your mat before bringing your right hand down, ground, ankle or shin. From here, place your hand on your sacrum, on your pelvis so you know you're nice and square, and then twist. Inhale, lengthen through the spine, and then exhale, twist. One more breath here. Exhale, come back and open back up to warrior two, reverse. And then come forward for our half moon. And maybe have a play here. Maybe come off your fingers. One finger, no fingers. Whatever you do, stay with your breath. It is your calming and grounding. Come into our supported warrior three and then standing splits. On your next exhale, bring your right foot to meet your left. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward. Inhale, come all the way up to stand. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step back to your high plank. Lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, press back, downward dog. Lift your right leg high, bend the knee, open the hip. And then slowly bring that right leg forward and into a pigeon stretch. So the left foot is near your left hand and your right knee is near your right hand. If you need to prop your hip up, you can place a pillow underneath here. Active foot. We want to protect our knee. And then when you're ready, inhale, grow tall. Reach, stay for the exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Feel yourself melting over your leg. Head rest down on the mat. And just take a moment to breathe. I want you to feel where that tightness is in your hips. I want you to bring completely non-judgmental awareness to that area of tightness. I want you to take a deep breath in and feel that area in your hip expand. And then as you exhale, feel like it's all flushing away. And it becomes a little bit more open and a little bit more loose. Every exhale, you let a little bit more go. Take three more slow, deep breaths here in your own time, your own space. And at the completion of that third breath, walk your hands back. Tuck your left foot under and press back up to a three-legged dog and draw some nice big circles with your knee. Get some life back in that hip. And then we come back to our downward dog. Inhale, the left leg high. Open the hip, bend the knee. Prepare for our pigeon and then slowly come forward. Right foot to the right hand, left knee. Left foot to the right hand, left knee to the left hand. Lower down again if you need to prop up here. That is totally fine. Grab a pillow. Inhale, grow tall. Lengthen. Feel like you're reaching out of your hips. Stay for the exhale. One more inhale, lengthen. And then exhale, melt over your knee. all the way down. And again, I want you to take your inhale. Feel that area of tightness in and around your hip joint. And then exhale, feel it all go. Feel every little muscle around that area, just relax that little bit more. Whatever we're holding in our hips, let it go. Slowly walk your way back, tuck the back toes and press back into our three-legged dog where you'll draw nice big circles with your hip. And then we come back to our downward dog. Inhale, rolling way, find our high plank and lower down all the way to the mat. Favorite cheek resting down. From here, bring your hands to create a cactus position. Looking over at your left hand, lift your left leg up and over. For a scorpion stretch, you should feel it all along the left line, crossing over to your right shoulder and chest. You can let the leg rest down if it's available, or it can just hang straight. Whatever feels the best for you right now. Close down your eyes. And just let gravity do its thing. Over to the other side, looking at your right hand as your right leg lifts up and over. Slowly come back. And from here, we're going to bring our hands down by your side. We're going to inhale, roll your shoulders down and reach your fingertips towards your feet. On the next inhale, I want you to lift your head. Stay. On the next inhale, I want you to pull your shoulder blades down that little bit more. Lift your chest. Stay. On the next inhale, lift your feet and lengthen them away from your head. Stay. One more inhale, can you reach your head further and your feet furthest away from each other as possible? And then on that next exhale, slowly lower and place your other favorite cheek down on the mat. This time, bring your fingertips forward. Looking down, we're going to inhale, lift your arms only. Hold. On the next inhale, lift your head. Hold. Inhale, lift your chest. Hold. Inhale, lift your legs. Hold. On the next inhale, reach your fingertips and your feet as far away as possible. Can you grow another few centimeters taller? Stay for one more breath. And then exhale it all down. Bend the knees. Windscreen wipe your feet from either side. Maybe in circles one way, circles the other way. When you're ready, bring your hands in by your chest again. Press up into our cobra or our upward dog. Stay here for a full inhale and an exhale. And then press back up, downward dog. I want you to slowly walk your feet in and come to our kneeling position. Cross the legs over and come to sit. From here, we're going to inhale, grow tall, active feet. Exhale, fold. Reaching the fingertips towards your feet, maybe that your calves or your shins, wherever you can get to today. We're going to inhale, halfway lift here. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen one more time. And then exhale, let it all go. Stay here for three breaths. Gentle tabletop to counter that fold. Knees bent, headrest back. And then slowly come back down. From here, we're going to slowly roll down one vertebra at a time, all the way down to the mat. Take a moment here. Now I've got yogi's choice. We can come into a bridge or a wheel. So a bridge involves feet flat, close enough that you could tickle your heels with your fingertips, pressing down through all four corners of your feet, lifting the hips high, and then walking your shoulders under, interlace your hands, press it into the mat. Option one. Option two is our full wheel, where our hands are behind, fingertips pointing towards our feet, and we press up into our full wheel. Whatever your choice is, I want you to stay here for five long, deep breaths before coming back down and having a few resting breaths. So in your own time, pressing up into our bridge or our wheel for five breaths here. when you're finished, rolling down one vertebra at a time, and then windscreen wipe your knees from side to side. Drop your knees down to the right. Hold it here. A gentle twist. Bring your knees over to the left and stay here. Now hug your knees into your chest. Our final posture before coming into Shavasana is Happy Baby. Should you choose to do shoulder stand as your inversion of choice, that is totally fine. I'm going to demonstrate Happy Baby today though. Reaching in between, big toes interlaced, knees pulled down towards your underarms. As you push your feet up towards the ceiling, creating this counter tension to help elongate your spine. Maybe you want to rock from side to side like a real happy baby. When you're ready, hug your knees into your chest and slowly let your legs come out long. Feet as wide as the mat, hands are out wide. Take up as much space as you possibly can. And then I want you to squeeze every muscle in your body like you're trying to pull your arms and your legs out of your torso. Squeeze your face muscles too. Hold. And then I want you to let every single muscle go. This is where we come into our Shavasana. Your time for reflecting on the practice, for resting down, for letting all the good things that you've done through this practice settle into your body. The chance to let all the stretches work through the tissues and the fascia and your muscles, and for the fresh oxygen to flow through all these new spaces we've created. So enjoy your Shavasana.
Thank you.
to deepen your breath. Come back to the room. Take note of what you can hear around you. What can you hear that's the furthest thing from you? What can you hear that's maybe in the room with you or coming from yourself? Can you feel the ground underneath your heels and the backs of your hand? The back of your head and your hips resting on the mat. Start to wriggle your toes and wriggle your fingers. Roll your wrists and your ankles. Rock your head from side to side. And give yourself a big stretch like you're waking up for the first time again this morning. In your own time, hug your knees into your chest. And slowly make your way into a tight little ball on your favorite side. Keep your eyes closed as you work your way up to a comfortable seated position with your hands at the heart center. Together, inhale and sigh it all out. That's every last bit of worry going. I thank you all for joining me this morning or for watching this later on. And I want you to take a moment to say thank you to yourself for attending and doing a practice and making yourself feel that little bit better in this crazy, crazy time. Together we say namaste. Thank you everyone. I hope you enjoyed the class. Thanks so much for watching. Please leave a comment if you enjoyed the class or if you have any other questions or suggestions for other classes that I could run for you all. As I said at the start, the PayPal link is in the description below. Feel free to donate if you feel like you can and you'd like to, $5, $20, whatever you can donate. And if not, I really just hope you enjoyed the class. I've added in my Instagram handle down below in the description as well. So it's Mindful Creature for our like business site, and I'm Sammi S. Smith, but it's all down there in the description if you'd like to keep in contact or send me a private message as well. Thank you so much everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed the class and take something home that's just going to leave you feel a little bit happier and healthier for the rest of today. So see you all next time on next Tuesday. I think I'm teaching a myofascial class where we're going to use foam rollers and spiky balls. So hopefully see you all then. Bye.